Hello, hello, ladies and gentlemen, your beloved Wingman here. Welcome back to the Unleash No Server. How are you guys doing? I hope you're doing great. I know I am. I'm over at the Mesa, far, far away from home, just mining up a couple of new blocks, because in today's episode, we are going to need a whole bunch of them. A lot of the orange ones, a lot of the red ones, and a lot of the other colors as well, I hope. I want to test out something new today, so stay with me, guys, because I think we might create history, make something epic happening, perhaps, I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see, I guess. Hope everyone has a tasty beverage by their side, just sitting comfortably, relaxing, and while hanging out with me for another episode here, where we are doing some freaking crafting. I've been over here for hours myself. Look at all of this I've gotten. The red sandstone is so hard to get. I don't know if you ever tried to get large quantities yourself, but it's a pain in somewhere I don't want to talk to you about right now. But it's really, yeah, it's a pain to get basically, because in the mesas, let's not forget this one here, but I'll put some of you in here as well. In the mesa, the sand spawns in only one block thick layer, if that makes sense. Let's see if I can find an example around here. I've almost mined out this whole freaking mesa, but like here you can see, it's only one block like high or tall or whatever thick of red sandstone or sand, and you need 4 stacks of the red sand to create a stack of red sandstone. So basically I have freaking mined out this whole mesa here. Like, as far as I can see, there's not really any any red sand left. Well, there might be a few patches like here and there, like that's a block and that's a block. But basically, like, all of this mesa around here has I dug out, because I need so much for my orange castle and my orange builds and all that stuff. So why don't I just go ahead and mine a little bit more, and I'll meet you back at my base for once. It's been a while. Home, sweet home. I can't remember the last time I was here together with you guys. We've been so focused on getting the ice track down that we have never actually been here in like 5 episodes, I do believe. That's insane. What a beauty this area is. What beauty it's turned out to be, and how glad I am that it worked out. My idea of making an orange town really worked out. So in today's episode, we are going to expand on this bad boy right here. Because basically, what all like medieval societies have or is based on, well, as far as I know, this is a medieval area, by the way, if you can't tell by the architecture. It's supposed to be placed in the Middle Ages, in somewhere like in Italy or Turkey or something like that. That's kind of what I was having a picture of in my mind when I was starting and figure out the style for this era here. So basically, medieval societies were often based around, of course, trading and, you know, farmland and stuff like that, but also about, like, around religion. Religion was a very big part of medieval societies, as far as I know. So what I want to do today is to craft... to create like some kind of church or religious build here in this town, because I think that would really fit in, like some kind of church or temple, something with a lot of spires, just kind of like I thought something around here that is like really occupying the sky and the skyline. Add a lot, like another feature to the skyline in this area. I think that will look pretty cool. This is supposed to be some kind of a layout for the build, but honestly, I don't have any idea of how to attack this build here. I just had this idea in my mind that we should have a religious build in a big town like this. Well, it's not that big yet, but it's going to be in the future. So my idea is that I have like a circular beginning part right here, like this one here with the clay going around like this. So this will be like the base of a tower, and the main tower of this building here will might have like a bell tower or something on the top, and it will be a little bit taller than the rest of the builds around here, just to make it dominate like the skyline on this area here. Of course, The castle is in the focus, but we'll have another smaller tower here, whatever you want to call it. And so yeah, my idea is to have like this rounded area here, which goes into a spire, and then we have like this almost like squaredish. I've added some shape to it just to make it look a little bit more interesting, I think. Also on the other side here, just mirrored. And I don't know what kind of gods these people would serve, but I think that's something you guys maybe could come up with, because I have no clue how to come up with a religion, or I don't know. Could you help me out perhaps with if they like serve the water gods, or perhaps they pray to the nature, or I don't know. Maybe you have any good ideas, or maybe you can come up with some cool things. But what we want to do is to try to make this build stand out when it comes to colors as well. So I want to use a little bit of brown stained clay as well here, together with the rest of the orange and red and stuff we already have. So I think it will look very, very interesting in the end. So I got the base of the main tower done. Of course, we need more details, we need more prettification, but the shape of it should be good right now. So we have like a small border of normal hardened clay in the bottom here. Then we have a row of smooth. And then some normal red sandstone and a little bit of orange clay, which just adds a little bit of variation here. And then some more, and I think we'll have to do some kind of detail trim or something here, and then escalate in with one or two blocks, and then like add another layer here to it, and then continue all the way till we get like a nice pointy spire on the top, which should be fairly epic, I do believe. I expect some kind of around four layers. If that makes sense. So this is one layer, and then we'll add like another one, which is a little bit smaller, the radius is a little bit smaller, and then another one, and so on, and so on, basically. So we'll get like a nice, nice, like, almost like cone-shaped tower. If you're following along here, that should be pretty cool. Man, do I love how this is turning out. Look at that beautiful next layer we just added, with some red in it. Hello, Russian Afro Man, welcome to the server. With a red we added up there, just add a nice tint of detail and love and tenderness. I love it. And what do you guys think about this layer here? But we also have to add a couple of more layers to make this tower or spire or cone, whatever you want to call it, look purely epic. So why don't we just go into fast building mode? That means I put on music and you watch me build. Have fun. I do believe we have a problem. I'm stuck in midair. How the heck do I get down from here? I don't know. Let's see, can I place some freaking blocks? Is that the one I'm lagging on? No, what the crap is going on? Dude, I'm dead. Okay. Oh, woo, okay, there we go. What actually happened right there? I don't know. Freaks me out a little bit when the ghost blocks appears. But what do you guys think of this beauty? I like it myself. It looks kind of like an Indian tribe. Native Americans, as you might say. But I like it. It really stands out. It catches your eye. And I'm not too sure about the brown part. But we'll have to play around a little bit with it. Maybe we can do some tweaks and stuff to make it look a little bit prettier. Maybe blend in a little bit more of the orange stuff up there to make it look a little bit pretty. But for now, I think we have a pretty decent design to work with. The shape is awesome. The height is perfect, exactly what I wanted. So I think we'll have to walk a little bit around the town here, just to kind of see how it feels when you're walking. So let's say we're over here. Yeah, you can see it. I kind of want you to be able to see it for most part, but I don't want it to be too dominating, like you see it like constantly. So kind of like this, you can still kind of see it a little bit. If we walk around back here, yeah, we can see it, but it's not too much. It kind of just, it sits there. You can see it above here. Here is Fred's bass. Do not feed or touch. No. Yeah, don't feed or touch. Yeah, anyway. and that's our creeper, by the way. Our pet, which we caught in a live stream way back. But I really like how it turns out. Right now you can't really see it, but I guess that's just because the tree's in the way. Yeah, but it works. Absolutely. Looks really nice. Let me know down below what you think of this design right here, and if there's any improvements you want me to do. But there's a lot of more stuff to do on this build here. We can't just leave it like this with a tower. We need to add a little bit on the back here to make it all pretty and stuff. I wonder how it will look if we try to add some sand in here to create a little bit of randomization. Oh, that looks smooth actually, I like that. Let's add a couple more like that without interrupting anything, which we clearly just did. Place you back there, something like that. Yeah, that works actually, I like that. I like having a little bit of randomization in my builds from time to time. So let's see how well this fits in. Yeah, I think that actually works pretty well, pretty well. We're done with the main structure of the build. Of course, there's a lot of detailing, a lot of stuff to work out. But as far from the shape of it, I love it. I love it a bit, actually. So if we like step back a little bit here. I love how the tower sticks out, but it's not too tall compared to the rest of the build here. Like this from the side, it looks really nice. It looks really even. Balance, if that makes sense. Of course, the tower is over detailed compared to the rest. We're getting there. We're going to do a lot of detailing on the areas here as well. So we'll have to just like add in a little bit of randomization at first, I do believe. That's a tip from me to you. Pro tip, if you're doing Minecraft builds, try add a little bit of randomization to them. It just makes the build pop alive a little bit more. At least in my opinion, something like this just makes it look really nice. I wonder what spruce will look like in the ceiling here. Something like this, I guess. I wonder what it will look like with some oak crossbeams in here as well. I like it, actually. I like it with the crossbeams. Looks really, really nice. So, guys, this building is really taking shape, and I'm loving it. I'm digging it. But the inside is a huge mess. Also, I need to sort out the ceiling up here. I don't really know what to do. Maybe we should do some kind of... like a diagonal roof going like this, or just keep it flat like the rest of the build. I don't really know. We'll get to that later. But for the inside here, so my idea is that you will go like walk here, go into the build, and inside here we will have one statue, two statues, three statues, four statues, whatever, how many gods or whatever these guys serve or pray to in this like dome here area. So they will have like maybe four will be good. One in each corner like this could be really nice. And then you can walk further in and this will be like the praying room. We'll have some seats and stuff where you can sit and pray, I guess. Make it look really cool and stuff in here. So the like statues here, I'm gonna wait with, cause I might wanna hear what you guys come up with if you have any good religion ideas and stuff like that. And also I need to figure out a design for them, cause right now I haven't done that many statues and stuff. But I guess we can do a little bit of this room back here before I leave you guys. So we need to first let's sleep a little bit, and then we need to grab some resources we need to do on the floor. I'm guessing like a stone combination would be good. Use some smooth stone, some cobblestone, some andesite, and all the jazz. I think that should be working pretty nice. So let's test what this combination of blocks here would look like if we somehow manage to do some cool stuff with them. It's really hard to sometimes do like the randomization of stuff, but I've been getting pretty good at it for a while. I've been playing Minecraft for too long, in my opinion, but I'm still digging in every single part of the game. So I've learned how to do the randomization a fair bit, at least, I guess. I really love doing the randomization bits, and something like this looks really nice. And it gives a nice contrast to the orange walls. So I really like this. I think we'll keep this for the whole room here, and also perhaps in this room. But I want to have some kind of centerpiece, or make some kind of pattern in the floor here. But we could also use this as the main blocks. But I want to have one center block perhaps, and then have some kind of pattern going around, like circles. I don't know. We'll figure something out, I guess. But for in here, I really like this just random block combination of the gray blocks we have in the game. Well, like at least the gray stone blocks we have in the game. It's really up my alley, if you say so. Alright, let's get to the seating, shall we? So what I kind of want to do is to have the middle part free from seats, but rather have the seats on the sides here, like they're sitting towards the center here, praying, I guess. Something like this could work, and then we'll do the same here. Like that. Of course, I'm running out of blocks. I'm not really that prepared. So let's see. Yeah, this is the last thing I want to do before I start adding some details to the outside, because I'm kind of running low on time already. It's getting really, really late, and Vigoman needs to get some sleep. Something like this. This era is like totally unfinished, but we'll get to that in another episode, or perhaps I'll do it off camera. Who knows? So yeah, just adding some of these seats here. Dude, I'm running so low on the stairs. They're just disappearing out of my inventory. They're vaporizing. Dude, that's the wrong block. Learn to craft, Vigo. Stupid idiot. This should be enough, I know for sure. Let's see here. You go there. That is not enough, I think. Something like that. Yeah. I like the feeling of this. Going in here. It's nothing too complicated, but I guess that's how most like temples and stuff are. You don't really focus much on the individual sitting there, because you're there to praise the god of this area. So what I want to do now, guys, is to add some kind of stained glass here. I had a little bit of glass paints, so we'll see if we can figure out a nice little design here that will look cool from the inside and the outside. Something like this. And what if I keep that going down, it looks like a cross. So I don't want to do that, just because I don't want these people to be Christians, even though I am myself. But I don't want this to be like I want this to be like a fictionary stuff. But how does that look? That is not too shabby, honestly. I like that. We could add a border down here, just to make it a little bit more interesting. Like this. Come on now, Vigo. Yeah. That is really, really cool. Let's check it out from the outside. This area here is a spawn trap. There's so many mobs spawning on it, I do believe. I haven't lit up anything. And from the outside, it looks a little derpy. It does. But I guess once we start adding some stuff on the back here, let's add like a support beam here for an example. Like this. Something like that. And then another one here. And things should start to look a little better, I do believe. Let's take a little step back. Yeah, just a small support like that just makes the build look a little bit more realistic. And it really gives a nice feel to it. I like it. So the final thing I wanted to do before I left you guys today was to add some more details to the tower. So I've done that. I've added some trapdoors on the second layer, you can see on the wooden columns there. Added some buttons and also on, let's see, we need to go back a little bit here. On the top layer, I've added some trapdoors as well, but also mixed in a little bit more orange, as I've talked to you guys about, because it didn't really match, but now I really feels like it smooths it out a little bit. I've added some orange in the middle here for a window, to represent the window, and I just really think it fades into the brown a little bit more. It really fits in, and just brings like the tower to a whole nother level, I do believe, in my opinion. But unfortunately, ladies and gentlemen, that is all I got time for today. So sad. It's been a great episode. I have had so much fun doing this build here. I hope you guys enjoyed watching. If so, make sure to smack that like button. And if you haven't done already, make sure to subscribe and all that stuff. And I will see you all guys later. It's been Vigoman, and I'm out.